away for months. Oh. Of course you'll like it. Even if you didn't, you wouldn't tell me. Guess that's what I love about you. You never want to hurt my feelings. Couldn't stand to be away from me for a minute, could you? Todd.
You got it on the first try.
What?
I'm out. The first thing I did was to come to see you.
Not that I need to hear this, but explain it to me again.
Well, if I'm right about this, it's not the flu vaccine that's contaminated. It's the syringes.
Wait, then everybody that got any kind of shot would be sick.
No, I think it's a specific combination of the flu vaccine and the contaminated syringes that allowed this deadly virus to breed.
Well, look, no matter how dangerous it is, it doesn't hold a candle to Grace Wrath of God Atherton. So hurry it up, Ben. If she catches us in here, we are dead, man.
Is it the flu or is it?
Larry, what is wrong with Vicky?
Well, it's like the flu, and right now it's frantically epidemic.
So this is what Mom's got, is this mystery disease?
I wouldn't call it a mystery, exactly.
Well, you don't know what to call it.
But Larry, she's so sick. It happens so fast.
Well, obviously she has a very aggressive case, but we've seen others move quickly. Evidently this has been brewing long before she went away with Jessica, and what makes the situation critical is she's developed pneumonia.
Pneumonia? You've got to let me in there to see her. Right?
Excuse me, if anyone has a right to be in there seeing her, it's all right.
All right, Spawn, you can go in there for a few minutes.
Thank you.
Look, you said this is critical. What does that mean?
Oh, honey, you know what that means.
She's going to recover, right? Larry?
What do you see?
Martin?
Check this out, right side of the slide.
Yeah, that's exactly what you're looking for.
Great. What is it?
Pseudoeurugi.
Okay.
What?
Pseudomonas aeruginosa.
Yeah, that's your cause.
Excuse me, guys, a translation for the layperson, please?
It's a bacterium, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It probably contaminated the syringes and packaging, most likely by exposure to water.
But you mean people are dying because of faulty packaging?
Well, that's oversimplifying it.
If this organism is exposed to any moisture, in this case, water in the syringes, or even the flu vaccine itself, it could provide a medium for the bacteria to grow.
But you keep saying probably, almost, most likely, maybe. Is this the answer or isn't it?
Rachel, this isn't like the law books. In medicine, it's very hard to draw an absolute conclusion, but in this case, I am as sure as anyone can be.
Well, why didn't someone spot it before?
In early stages of infection, Pseudoeurugi mimics the flu, so most of the patients were probably just given antibiotics and sent home before any culture was taken.
Okay, so if people are suffering from this bacterial contamination and not the flu, can you treat it?
There are antibiotics that'll treat it.
Yeah, but which ones?
Well, we have to research that next.
No, you have to research that. I am out of here.
Martin?
No way, Dad. Look, you asked me to help you identify the organism, and I did that as a favor to you and a great risk to me. I've got two mortgages and a beauty of a sports car to pay off. I cannot risk losing my job because you've got some hunch.
It's more than a hunch. You just saw it, man.
Oh, I'm sorry, Ben. I can't risk losing my job. You've already been suspended from this place. If she catches me in here, I am dead.
But don't say that. That stuff airborne?
No.
Martin, thanks for the help.
Get out of here.
Yeah, you don't have to tell me twice.
Goodbye, and good luck.
Ben, wait. Maybe we should go back to my apartment. I mean, Martin is right. If Grace Atherton comes in here, it's the end of your brilliant medical career.
Well, Rachel, I'm glad to hear you think my career is brilliant. And I am the Man of Steel, but I can't haul these books anywhere.
There's too many of them, they're too heavy, and there's just no time.
Look, Grace Atherton comes
in. We've managed to stay one step ahead of her so far. Let's just hope we can keep up the pace, okay?
Victoria Buchanan.
She's critical.
Victoria Lord Buchanan? Oh, great. She's one of Landview's most prominent citizens.
That's the least of my concerns.
She owns the banner, for heaven's sake.
She is also a good friend of mine. And I'd appreciate it if you would stop talking about her like she's a public relations risk and start addressing the fact that she's seriously ill.
There has to be a way to limit the hospital's liability and control the bad press.
Why don't you try controlling this epidemic instead?
What exactly is it that you want from me, Miss Price?
I want you to put more research effort into this, Grace. In fact, if you hadn't given Ben the bum's rush out of this place, maybe we'd know what's causing this nightmare already.
That's sibling loyalty speaking. And under other circumstances, I'd respect it, but here it's just plain inappropriate. You have to remain objective.
I am being objective, Grace. You're not.
I don't have time to debate this with you. If your brother hadn't given that interview to Clint Buchanan for the banner, he wouldn't have been suspended. Now, if you will excuse me.
Oh, where is it, you couple with adding machine?
What was that? What's this? Oh, thank you. Hold on, and I'll get you the AD-40s. These have to go up to Dr. Wallach for his signature and then on to Commonwealth Crisis Management.
Yes, Miss Atherton. Mm. By the way, I'm so glad you and Dr. Price have resolved your differences.
You mean Sheila Price? She's not an MD, Eleanor, and as far as
no,
her
ma'am,
brother is concerned.
I meant Ben Price.
There's been no reconciliation between Dr. Price and myself.
But he left your office just a little while ago.
This office?
Is this how you deal with making plans? Believe me, when I get you home a couple of days from now, you're going to get a real piece of my mind. You're the only reason I'm even sitting here. You gave me a reason to live. Let me do the same for you. I'm planning a whole future for us. It just wouldn't be fair for you to leave me now. Please, Vicky. Don't leave me. Don't leave me. Yes, darling. I'm here, Vicky. I'm right here.
I gotta wear this stupid gizmo on my legs so they know where I am every second of every day, and I gotta go to these stupid therapy sessions, but basically I'm free. I'm a free man.
I had no idea it would happen so quickly.
Well, it wouldn't have without you.
Me?
Yeah. When you went to Statesville and you pleaded my case at the hearing, you really turned the governor's aide around. Turned me around, too.
What do you mean?
Well, I'd given up on everything, and then when I saw that, you still believed in me. I mean, look at me, Rebecca. I'm practically a new man because of you.
Todd, I think it's wonderful that you've gotten another chance, and I believe that you can start over, but I can't...
Hey, look at me, you know? I'm sitting here, okay? I'm already a different man. I mean, when I was in prison, all I would do was walk around all day and half the night. I mean, wherever I was, I'd be walking back and forth like some kind of animal in a zoo. And now, I'm at peace. It's like, I don't know, it's like I can finally rest, you know? Nobody's chasing me.
Todd, there's something I have to tell you.
Wait. There's just one more thing. Now, look, I know I've been talking blue streak since I walked in here, but just one more thing, okay?
Go ahead.
Well, I heard about Powell.
What about Powell?
Well, I ran into Kevin, and he told me that you and Powell had split up.
When did you talk?
Well, look, it doesn't really matter. Now, just hear me out. Now, I know that you're upset about this now. But I know that in time, you're going to see that this is all for the best.
No,
because it is, Rebecca, it is. You must know that Powell wasn't the one for you. Yeah, I know you do know that deep down in your soul. And I would never be telling you any of this if I was still locked up. But since we're both free... I love you, Rebecca.
Hey. Just heard about Vicky. How's she doing? Is she any better? Well, how about you guys? How are you holding up?
Well, we're a little shook up. Uncle Larry asked us to clear out of ICU, so we're all taking turns seeing her.
Is that bad?
I was getting ready to leave, and I overheard someone saying that they brought Vicky into emergency. I couldn't believe it. I still can't. That room, that's where I first met her.
But Megan was sick.
Yeah, I was so awful to her back then. But that was a lifetime ago, Marty. A couple of lifetimes ago. Megan's and Swade's. Gosh, and now Vicky's got this horrible flu. Maybe she could be...
Honey, Vicky's gonna be fine.
Listen, I better go check on my dad.
Okay.
You two will be all right here?
Marty, I know that you were really close to Vicky, but you're taking it so hard.
I am just so sick of losing people.
You are not going to lose Vicky. Marty. Honey, is there something else you want to talk about? Earlier, I heard them gossiping at the nurse's station. And they said that Todd Manning is working here. Is that true?
Yeah, it's true. Kathy, I tell you, with losing the house and having to be in the same building as Todd Manning and now Vicky.
Listen, maybe there's something I can do to make things a little better.
It looks like a funeral arrangement. I'm sorry, but it does.
I know that you're upset. You should be upset. But I thought that they...
Adam, Joey.
Hey.
Oh, how are you guys doing?
Oh, never mind, stupid question.
Well, we're hanging in. Thanks for dropping by, Grandma.
Where else would I be?
Hey, how's Luna?
She's hanging in as well. I'll tell her you asked.
Okay. Oh, don't look now, but Grandpa wants you, and you don't want to keep him waiting.
Sure I do.
Nice flowers.
Thank you.
Alex, are you on your way to a funeral?
This is no time for dark humor, Renee.
This is the best time for dark humor. How are you doing, Renee?
I was here arranging for physical therapy for Luna, and I heard about Vicky. I didn't want to press the boys. How is she, Asa?
Not too well. I'm going to check and see if Clint's here yet. I'll be right back.
Oh, Renee?
Yes?
This is really a time for family. Maybe you should come back later.
Vicky?
eyes were just open. She was awake.
Well, it might just be a reflex.
She said my name.
Sloan, she'll be slipping in and out of consciousness. It doesn't necessarily mean anything one way or the other. Are you all right? I don't like the stress you're under.
Well, what should I be doing? Playing golf at the country club? Give me a break.
I'm sorry. I'm just concerned about you.
Well, I'm fine. Tell me how she is.
The condition's still critical.
Does that mean you're going to pitch me out of here?
No. Now, you stay here a few more minutes. Then you will have to go.
Thank you.
We just heard. How is she? Jessica, she's going to be fine, honey. Uncle Larry's taking care of her now. She's going to be all right. Look, why don't you go down and wait in the sunroom with your brothers? I'll be down soon. Could she get so sick so quickly?
It's this same flu-like illness that Ben and I told you about the other day.
The one that killed Duff Garvey and the others?
We're doing everything. She just is not responding to conventional treatment. But don't worry, we'll give her everything we got. Yeah, sure.
I'll be outside.
She's just not responding to treatment.
You checked her records before this.
Yeah, the flu shot. She's had it just like every other fatality we've seen here.
No, Vicky is not going to be a fatality. If Grace hadn't suspended Ben, he could be working on this thing right now.
Call him. Ben, call Ben right now. Look, I don't care if Grace Atherton has apoplexy. Ben has been working so hard tracking this thing down, he might have answers for us. Just because Grace Atherton has a large ego and a short fuse, I'm not going to sacrifice any chance to save Vicky. Call him. Got it.
You got it, really? Woo, let's go.
Whoa. We can't just run through the hospital broadcasting the Ben Price choice of antibiotics.
Sure you can.
No, if Grace sees me, she'll have us thrown out.
Okay, what do you do?
Clint. All right, we need to call him, give him an information update for the banner.
Yes, may I speak with Clint Buchanan, please? It's urgent. Okay, thank you. He's here.
What, in the hospital?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
I don't know, they didn't say.
Okay, see if you can find him.
Well, where will you be?
Right here. I just want to triple check my facts before I recommend this treatment for anybody.
Okay, I'll get Clint.
Okay, cool. Rachel. Thanks.
You don't have to thank me.
No, thank you for having faith in me.
Well, it was easy.
I care about you, but
See, I knew it. I knew it. I knew it ever since we were together at the River House.
No, Todd, listen to me. Things are different now. They're very different from when we were there.
Well, what's different?
My feelings for you are different. And then there's Powell.
Yeah, but you and Powell are over now.
No, it's not
over. Kevin told me.
No, Kevin was wrong. Powell and I are still together. I love Powell.
No, don't. You shouldn't lie to me, Rebecca. Rebecca. Powell was here last night? All night?
Yes. Yes, he was.
Powell was here last night. But he, like, fell asleep right at me. Nothing happened. Remember what you told me the first time we talked about all this?
I wanted to wait until we were married, but not if that means you think...
Shh. Once we're married, we'll have all the time in the world. But I want it to be right for you. I want it to be perfect. Rebecca, nothing happened between you and Belle last night, right?
Yes. We made love. Todd, listen to me, please. I care about you. Very, very much. I want you to have a wonderful life. I want you to have the life that God intended you to have. But I can't be part of that. I promised Powell that I wouldn't be involved with you once you left Statesville, and I meant it. I won't.
You're my whole life, Rebecca. Without you, I didn't care whether I lived or died, whether I walked free or spent the rest of my life in prison. I can't do any of this without you.
No, you have to. Look, you've been given a miraculous new chance. Look, I know that you don't feel good about your life right now. I know that you don't feel worthy about
it. Don't you analyze me?
You need help.
Well, then help me, Rebecca. Don't turn your back on me.
I can't help you. You need a therapist.
I don't want a damn therapist.
All I ever wanted is you.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
Rebecca, hey, it's me.
Oh, Powell.
Listen, I'm at the hospital.
Are you all right?
Yeah, no, I'm fine, but it's Vicky. She's really sick.
I'm sorry. Well, can I do something? Can I call people
for you? No, it's all right. The whole family's down here, but I sure could use some...
I'll be right there, okay?
Okay.
Just hang on.
You know, as far as I can remember, I have never, ever lied to you guys. So if I say your mama's gonna be fine, you know you can take that to the bank.
I told you.
Renee. I really thought you might be intelligent enough to take my advice.
And what was that again?
To leave. If anybody should be comforting those children, it should be me. After all, I'm going to be their new
grandmother. The word is grandmother. Can you say grandmother?
That's not the point.
Oh, that is exactly the point. Despite my divorce from Asa, I am their grandmother. And more a part of this family than you'll ever be.
Why not? I just can't. Doesn't have to be forever, just until you find a new place to live. You two have a new baby to take care of. The last thing you need is for me to be underfoot, too.
Oh, yeah, so you're not going to come babysit for us?
No, you can call me anytime to babysit, but I...
But nothing. You keep talking as if you're going to be a burden.
Cassia, I feel that way a little. When I look back over the past few years, I keep remembering things like when Bo and Nora had to walk me around my hotel room because I almost OD'd, drinking on top of too many drugs, and... You and Andrew babysitting me for weeks, months after the rape.
Are you forgetting the part when you looked in after me, when I lost William?
No. It's just the past 8 months or so, I finally started. I feel like I've learned to be self-sufficient again. I don't want to go back to being a burden to people that are supposed to be my friends, that are my caretakers.
Maddie, I'm not asking you to come stay with us because I think you need support. I'm asking you to come stay with us because you need a place to live.
I can live anywhere.
Marty, that's not the point. What's happening with Vicky is a reminder of how important family is to me.
I just can't, Cassie. Marty, you're part of my family.
You are. Say you'll at least think about it.
Okay, I'll think about it.
Rachel, hey.
Kevin, I need to talk to your father. Why is everyone here?
Mom is really sick.
Oh, I'm sorry. What happened?
That flu thing.
Vicky? No. Hey, listen. Ben can help.
Ben?
Yeah.
Grace, you've got to hear me out.
No, you've got to get out. You're in violation of
my suspension. I know, I'm suspended. But I couldn't walk away from the research. Not with so many lives at stake.
Not to mention another really good photo op for the banner.
Listen to me. I figured out what's causing this epidemic.
Oh, great. Another of your ridiculous theories.
No, it's not just a theory. I know what it is. I've seen it with my own eyes, and I know how to stop it.
Oh, come off it, doctor. Last time I listened to your folderole about this flu vaccine, I don't want to listen to any more of your ludicrous theories this time.
I was half right.
Which makes you half wrong. Now, I want you to get out of here.
It was the flu vaccine.
Oh, for crying out loud.
In conjunction with contaminated syringes that allowed this lethal bacteria to develop.
You're on hospital property, and I want you out of here right now.
What is with you? Why don't you want to hear me?
Because you no longer work here, mister.
Pending review by the medical board. Meanwhile, I'm telling you that I've got a solution to a problem that's killing people in your hospital, and you don't even want to hear about it? I have cross-checked every single case of this illness looking for a common denominator. And only people inoculated with contaminated syringes got sick.
The syringes?
Sherman Vance brand. The ones that you changed to back in February. Now tell me, Grace, why did you choose this particular brand? Could it have been part of your austerity program here? Could it be that this brand was just plain cheaper? Well, people have died because you're so cost-conscious. So tell me, what kind of savings is there in that, huh?
You can't be right.
No, I am right. And I'm going to do something to stop this thing right now.
Vicky Buchanan.
What?
Victoria Lord Buchanan, she's lying in the intensive care unit right this minute.
Ah, no.
If what you say is true, then she...
It is true, Grace. Deal with it.
Look, this isn't my fault.
Get real, will you? I gotta find Larry. Tell him what I know.
Oh, no. You're not going anywhere.
Maybe you should go home for a bit. You know, see your kids, get your mind off things for a while.
Corey has the kids all day. I called him earlier.
Okay, well, maybe you should go home for a break anyway. You know, lie down, relax.
No, I just can't leave, Vicky. I know I'm not doing any good by being here, but I just can't leave.
You're very devoted to your sister.
Our sister. I just can't leave until I know she's okay.
Yeah.
How nice of you to decide to come back. I've made a very important decision.
Really? Chartreuse walls in the master bedroom.
No, darling. I've decided that I can postpone our wedding until Vicky recovers so that she can come.
Alex, darling, recovered or not, Vicky will not be coming to our wedding.
You could at least invite her.
There'll be no lords or Buchanans, for that matter, in attendance. No one wants to see their old man married to, what I mean is, married again.
We'll see about that.
How is she? Is she better? Did she wake up?
Well, I've been with her. I'm sorry, there's no change.
She's got to get better.
Yeah, she's doing her best. So is everybody here at the hospital. What? What is it?
I was so mean to her for so long. She doesn't get better.
Me to tell you.
Mrs. God, Larry, she's completely unresponsive. She looks, frankly, she looks like hell. I guess I just want you to tell me that she's gonna be okay, Larry.
Clint, I'm sorry. I mean, this is like no other flu we've ever treated.
Well, what if it isn't the flu? I mean, have you talked to Ben Price?
Yeah, Sheila's trying to find him. We can't find him anywhere.
Well, can you beep him? Maybe he's found some answers.
All right, I will go track him down.
Thanks.
You just wait right here, all right?
I won't move.
I'm listening.
Okay, Ben thinks he found the cause of the infection, maybe, and a way to treat it.
Where is he?
He's in his office right now.
Well, where's his office?
Come on, I'll show you.
I'll stay here and keep an eye on him.
Of course.
Grace, you can't keep covering this thing up.
I'm not even remotely interested in your insane speculations. Nor do I intend to let you disturb the Buchanan family or the hospital staff with any more of your rantings.
Oh, no. Let's just disturb them with another fatality from an illness that went untreated because you have a heart of stone. Get out of my way, Grace. Oh, what, you think you can stop me?
Oh, I think I can. Gentlemen? I made arrangements for your escort when I found out that you were in the hospital. These gentlemen will see you out of this office.
Grace, you have no right to do anything like...
Oh, but I do. You're trespassing on hospital property in violation of your suspension from this institution. These nice fellows will keep you company until the police arrive to arrest you.
Over my dead body. Hey, hey.
Clint, he can take you to...
Where's Ben?
Ben?
Ben who?
Tina and the children would like to see Vicky for a few moments, if it's possible.
Code blue!
God, it's Vicky. Come on, everybody. I see you. Come on. Push Effie. Come on. Let's go. Get going. Okay. Effie, push. Okay, everybody stand clear. Clear.
All clear. Nothing.
Come on, push Effie again.
Good.
We'll do it again. Clear.
All clear.
All right. Come on.
Go.
Push Effie again. Pump it up to 3.
300
joules. 300 joules? Okay, all right. Clear. Come on, Vicky. Go, keep it going.
Get the laryngoscope.
All right, push the Effie. Keep it going.
Come on.
Keep it going.